I saw the sign myself, bro.
You saw the sign?
Mm-hmm. It told me. The sign. My eyes, I saw the sign.
So these chicks are sisters? And in this video, they kiss? That is so hot. That was way before Pornhub and the stepsister thing.
You up?
So, welcome everybody to Shots Fired and actually a special episode of Talk Shit. Now, this is not shit talk. You may have heard we're doing another podcast called Shit Talk, which is actually the guys from our St. Louis retail store and the guys that work at Tactical Shit that are not me, and they're doing their own podcast. Mm-hmm. I haven't listened to it. I don't know if it sucks or not, but you should go listen to it. It's on all the typical places you'd find the podcast. It's called Shit Talk. This is Shots Fired, episode motherfucking 50. Episode 50. And I've got Tony Anthony from Woobies in the house as my special guest today.
What's up, bud?
And we go way back.
Like, yes, we do.
You know, like, at least way as in like 2013, 2014, yeah. Something like that.
Yeah, yeah.
I met this motherfucker on the roof of the Moment Hotel. On the Sunset Strip. Dude. Now, we're not going to talk about this a lot, but this is a moment in time, right? Mm-hmm. We met on the roof of the Moment Hotel. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know why? Mm-hmm. I know that still because I stole two of their coffee cups, and I drink mm-hmm. from my Moment coffee cups almost every day. But it was you, me, Matt Best, Vincent Vargas, and a bunch of other dudes up on the roof. I'm pretty sure Clint Romachet had just got done telling a story, and I was like, who's that dude?
Dude, I just saw his movie for the first time, man.
Oh, my God.
Dude, that shit was
awesome.
Sick, dude. Yeah. They made Clint look sexier than he really is.
Yeah, for sure. But
Clint, I'm sorry, bro. You're not that fucking hot. Dude.
He's definitely.
They have like Clint, like, and then they have like Eastwood playing him or some shit.
Yeah, I don't think it was Eastwood, but it was
Jesus.
Something. Yeah, it was definitely sexier than the real thing. But that's how TV works, right?
Yeah.
I'm sure if they ever like do a movie about me, you know, it's going to be a much better looking guy, which is going to be hard to cast.
I don't know. I think we could do Adam Baldwin, dude.
I like it.
Yeah, like everybody who's listening right now, I've always told this guy from day one, he looks like a Baldwin dude. Like straight up, man.
So we met in Hollywood on the roof of a building, getting drunk. You were telling me about sexual Windex, sexual 409, and how to use window cleaner as a lubricant.
That was fun.
If that's all you've got, you know, that's how I knew that you were a badass, that you will improvise, adapt, and overcome in any situation.
That's a true story.
Yeah.
Do you want me to elaborate for like 10 seconds?
One second. So I just got to go ahead and set it up. So this is back at Range 15. When we were setting up, when we were creating Range 15, the movie Hollywood didn't want us to do, that's when I met this guy. And he told me the Windex story. He told my wife, actually, the 409 story. Go ahead and tell a story real quick.
Well, dude, so, I mean, I've been an entrepreneur my whole life. And before I started Woobies, I was still in Special Forces. And I had a buddy that I was making a security company with. And he's an attorney up there in Philly. So I showed up. I showed up on a Monday. I was supposed to leave on Monday night.
Yeah.
And he's like, okay, well, I'm still in the middle of meetings. You know how it goes. You know, go up there and drink my liquor and then go down to the bar, meet me. So I went down to the bar, met him. I was pretty sauced up. Next thing I know, I'm talking to a bartender and like super hot, you know, and I'm from Baltimore at the time,
right.
D.C. area. Next thing I know, I'm, you know, banging her out, right?
Yeah, you're at her house.
Is banging her out.
You're,
no condom.
Yeah.
Like
Raw dogging.
And I'm like, fuck it. And then, so she got mad at me. And then, because she was a stripper.
Yeah.
Right?
Of course.
Yeah, but she was the hottest stripper. So I went to this bar. She's like, we got to go to this bar. We actually have to go to this bowling alley. Right.
Yeah.
So I went to the bowling alley and I just drank water the whole time. And they stole my boots. They stole my jacket, put it in the trash. And this really fine ass bartender was like, I'll take you to my bar. Like when I get off,
mm-hmm.
She thought I was like a wounded dog or something.
Right. She felt sorry for you.
Yeah. 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 So we were like at my buddy's his attorney. He's got like seven rooms, no sheets on one of these beds. And, you know, I'm getting rug burned and stuff. I'm banging this girl out, you know, high end. And I was like, dude, we're still having fun, but like we need a new lube.
Yeah. Right? Cause she was dry, right? She was like,
after a while. And I got that.
Menopausal, do that.
And I got
that.
She was like 22.
Yeah.
But I'm a Mexican.
She was the owner of the bar's grandmother.
Like I'm like, no one even knows what my race is, dude. So like I have all these weird ass, you know, my penis is special. So what I was saying is this, is I went to fucking this dude's house, dude.
Yeah, so you have no lube, you got a dry stripper in your bed, and you're trying to find a way to get this problem solved to get back to fucking. With your
special. So right. he's passed the fuck out, right? Yeah. So I'm going through his drawers and everything from his fucking laundry room to the upstairs bathroom like a fucking frantic ass.
You're looking for like gun oil.
Just give me something. Give me some liberal tears.
Yeah, liberal tears. Bacon.
But they weren't around by then. You know what I'm saying? Right. So like, I'm in this fucking house and I found a fucking cabinet had 409. All right, brand new 409 bottle. All right. And I was like, this girl's waiting for me.
For those of you that don't clean, 409 is a window cleaner. That's also multi-surface. Yeah. Anyway.
Yeah, so I took it and I dumped it out in the sink, and I was dumping it. But every time I filled it up with water, it kept on having soap suds.
Right.
I was like, fuck. I was like, you know what? Dude, this girl's waiting for me. So I took it about halfway full, kind of soapy.
So it's diluted 409.
Kind of soapy, though.
Kind of soap,
kind of soapy.
Yeah, in a spray bottle.
Mm-hmm. So I take it upstairs and I start spraying her pussy, dude. Just pop, 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 pop. Give her like a 3-round burst. Pop, pop,
shots
pop, pop,
fired.
Pop. Yeah. Pop, 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 pop. And then I'd fuck her for a minute. And then she'd be all mad at me. Then I'd fucking hit it up. But the thing is, her pussy was starting to bleed a little bit because like that chemical reaction, cum, like
stinging a little
girls
bit.
Cum, men's cum. Yeah. And that fucking traction, 409 did not sell that as a lubricant.
The 50th podcast is the one that gets us shut down. After all the shit we've ever done and talked about, this is probably the end of it right here. So you solved the problem and you went back to work. And for that, I commend you because I've never forgotten that story. It doesn't matter how drunk I was on the roof of that Hollywood hotel. I will always remember that 409 works as a sex lube, although it will burn.
Yes, it does.
Do you want to pull that up? You just have to let me know when you want to pull the story up.
Oh, well, you know what? We probably ought to get into some news. So first of all, this is a Shots Fired because we do have some shots that were fired that we need to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
A 23-year-old legal CCW holder was shot by a 17-year veteran of the Franklin County Sheriff's Office. What city was that in? Was that in Baltimore or Philly?
Franklin County Sheriff's Office?
Yeah, somewhere. Come on, scroll. It's got to be here somewhere. I should have been more prepared. Columbus, Ohio. Okay.
Damn.
So in Ohio, basically, this dude he's got no record whatsoever. Wow. He's a legal CCW holder, 23 years old. Mm-hmm. His skin is darker than ours.
Mm-hmm.
And he is trying to get inside his house. He's got his keys in the front door.
Mm-hmm.
Turning the keys, and he's confronted by a fugitive task force officer who ends up shooting and killing him on his front porch.
Mm-hmm.
The fugitive task force officer says it's because he had a gun.
Mm-hmm.
Well, of course he had a gun. He had a legal right to have that gun.
Mm-hmm.
He was on his property. And I'd be willing to bet you, this is not part of the story, but me being an ex-cop, I'd be willing to bet you a fugitive task force means this guy was wearing blue jeans and a t-shirt. Right? Maybe a bulletproof vest. Maybe it said police.
Hold on a second. Hey, there's one thing that people don't know about that listen to this. I was a fugitive task force too.
Were you?
With the marshals.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. In New Mexico.
Yeah,
like,
this is
on
a
air.
U.S. Marshals task force
on air right now. Like, you can fact check me. And I was never in somebody's house as they showed up, unless I was clearing something in a weird way myself.
Right.
So, but I wouldn't have shot the dude though.
Yeah, so this is a completely weird shooting. It did not get immediate traction, although they said that there are protests now scheduled in the Columbus area. You know, Black Lives Matter is finding out about this. But I don't give a shit what color this guy is. The fact is that, first of all, they didn't even bring in the state to investigate the shooting until 2 days later, and the state has now declined to investigate because they were not privy to the original evidence.
Mm-hmm.
And you got a situation where, you know, you have a legally armed guy on his property next door to a place that they were going to raid, you know, looking for a fugitive, and they end up killing this
guy. So what were they there for, though?
Oh, let's see here.
Like, was he, like, selling fucking illegal goddamn, you know, Legos or something
for Christmas? There was no body cameras, because they don't have body cameras.
Okay.
No criminal
background, exactly.
It says, witness testimony and physical evidence raised serious concerns as to why Casey was even confronted, let alone why he was shot entering his own home.
Dude, they might have even got the address wrong.
Well, I'm pretty sure they were investigating something next door.
Exactly.
Let's see here. If we
see what I'm thinking? Like, they probably, you know, it's a human error, man.
Yeah, that happens all the fucking time. And as we defund the police, it's going to happen even more because you're going to have more and more fucking losers becoming cops.
Yeah, because they don't have any fucking training.
They don't have the training. They don't have the money for the training, and they don't have the desire. They don't have the dynamics.
Let me be honest with you. Like, this is a good topic, and I'll be straight up. People are probably going to fucking hate me over this, dude, but maybe love me. The police departments, TJ and I are both ex cops. Like, it is on record. However, like, you need to fund these motherfuckers.
Yeah, because they
need to get them. Like, you can't be shutting fucking like police academies down from 9 weeks to 6 weeks because you have no funding, because your fucking city manager is a goddamn politician and your chief that you just fucking got from another city. Like, that's the thing that's going on right now in Dallas, basically. Like, you cannot defund the police. What you need to do is get rid of the bad ones.
Yeah.
So you spend less money right now getting rid of the bad police.
If they just made that a mission, I could get behind that.
It's easy.
If they did a witch hunt.
It's easy as fuck, dude. Yeah, it's just so easy.
Go to every department and say, okay, who's the fuck?
And look at their past.
Look, dude,
you know how many police right now are like in every city of the world are getting in trouble and they've been getting in trouble on the job? You just got to get rid of them because it would cost you less money right now to defund the police just to get rid of them.
Yeah.
God damn. Yeah. Like, you guys can't defund the police, man. I mean, here's what I'm going to say. What's going to happen is that if you don't like the cops, I'm not saying I like them or not, but you're going to ask for them when you need them. So don't be a fucking bitch and be like, oh, I hate the cops, but I fucking call them when I need them.
Yeah, that's
a bitch ass move.
Be an asset, take care of yourself.
Nobody's
coming, but you know what? If the shit really hits the fan, you're probably calling 911 like everybody
else. Calling 911.
So anyway, in this case, though, I think this cop, I want to see where this case goes. Mm-hmm. According to this, it says Meade, the cop, was working with the U.S. Marshals Fugitive Task Force looking for violent offenders at the time. Mm-hmm. But Goodson was not the person being sought by the task force. Mm-hmm. Now, we don't know if maybe somebody else at the house was being sought or if it was next door or whatever. But anyway, he had a Subway sandwich in his hand, and his keys were still dangling in the door as the murder investigation.
Dude, that Subway sandwich will kill the fuck out of somebody.
Oh, man.
You know what I'm saying? Especially if you're black.
And
you know what I mean?
So the point I'm making, though, is, you know, we have 9.3 million first-time gun buyers out there, 9.3 million first-time CCW holders in a nation where most states are constitutional carry, not requiring training because it's my right to carry a gun. But it's your responsibility to get training. And so you got all these people out here with guns. You're going to have more situations like this with untrained, defunded cops shooting, you know, untrained CCW holders.
Exactly.
And so it's just a giant clusterfuck. But anyway, we've only got like another, I don't know, 16 minutes to do this podcast. We've got to move on. So this is an issue. We are going to watch this case. We're going to see where this goes. Hopefully it's not just swept under the rug, because it sure seems like it's being swept under the rug. Like, I don't know why Black Lives Matter doesn't like this kid. Maybe his skin isn't dark enough. But they're not making a big deal out of
this. He's a fucking... Fuck the media, dude. We all know that, dude. These are a bunch of assholes, dude. We'll start our own media companies here in the next 10 years, dude.
And we'll put out.
We'll put out whatever... Hey, we make up our own fucking magic, you know? We'd be like, hey, dude, this fucking rabbit killed a dog. And you'd be like, hey, fuck dogs.
Fuck dogs.
Fuck dogs, dude.
Hey, speaking of fuck dogs...
Everybody loves dogs, dude.
Speaking of fuck dogs, you just gave me the best segue in the world, because today we just learned from the Wall Street Journal that the ATF, lovers of dogs, raided Polymer 80's office, claiming that Poly 80... Now, that's the company that makes the 80% Glock.
Yeah, we were talking about that all day.
Now, Poly 80 also has a designation letter from the ATF stating that their 80% lower is... not a firearm. However, they were raided. Shitloads of stuff was seized. Nobody was arrested. No charges have been brought. But the ATF is accusing them of allegedly distributing firearms, failing to pay excise tax, shipping firearms across state lines, and failing to do 4473 background checks with specifically their buy, build, shoot kit, which I had a bad feeling about. We stopped selling them very early when I found out about them being a product that, you know, we sell Poly 80.
Yeah.
I immediately shut it down because I'm like, look, you know what? That You can't sell an 80 and a parts kit and a barrel and a bulk carrier.
No, you did the right thing. You know, you did the right thing the whole time.
Here's a 10-second gun, folks. Yeah. That's no longer an 80% build.
But you've done everything since the ATF are fucking around. You stopped it anyways.
Yeah, well, we stopped it before that.
You know? Yeah,
we
yeah,
sold
yeah.
These things since like last year.
It's just one of those
things
like...
you know, probably August. But anyway.
Yeah.
So that's a big deal. We're going to be watching this. It is a big, big deal.
I think it's a big deal, too.
Every article is calling it the ghost guns. The biggest ghost gun manufacturer in the country, raided by the ATF.
So hold on, ATF. Are you guys going to stop fucking letting people make 3D anythings?
That's next, dude. If Biden gets elected, they've already said they're going after. Let's talk about that real quick.
Yeah.
If you look and study, like I've done, Kamala Harris and Biden and their position on guns, first thing they're going to do in the first 90 days is two executive orders. The first one's going to enforce universal background checks, which I don't give a fuck about.
Right.
All right.
Yeah.
I don't care if you have to get a background check to sell a gun to your friend or if you have to get a background check at a gun show. I don't give two fucks. I will get the background check because I'm not a bad guy. I'm not worried about it.
That's easy, right?
The next thing, though, the next thing's bad. They're going to ban the importation of semi-automatic rifles, which is why they're going after arm braces in the import world, calling those guns AOW. Because if they ban the importation of semi-automatic rifles, then companies like CZ are just going to put arm braces on everything. And so they're going to ban the arm braces next. So importation of rifles, they're going to ban the arm braces.
If they do this, TJ, here's my question. Could we go to Kamala's house and Biden's house and see what kind of guns they have?
Yeah. You know what? All we have to do is go out to the Secret Service guys.
I'm running
MP7s.
It's mostly MP7s.
Yeah, it's mostly MP7s.
Yeah.
With armor-piercing
if you guys want to keep on taking shit from us, if you guys want to keep on taking shit from us and stop being bitches, dude. Yeah. I mean, honestly, like the government would never be even questioned if you guys ran your shit the right way. You know what I mean? It's like a fucking goddamn, it's like the Bachelorette every time you look at the fucking government. It literally is. It's like, it's a fucking full of shit, dude. And you can hate me for it. I don't give a fuck. Okay. I sell shoes anyways.
You sell shoes. Well, let's talk.
And I sell tactical gear, but what's up?
now that we got the news out of the way, we're going to move on because, again, we're running low on time because you have to be on an airplane back to Dallas. And I really appreciate
it. It's only first class, dude. They'll get me back there real quick, man.
I appreciate you coming to St. Louis and hanging out with me.
Dude, I appreciate you, Big Cat. Come on, man.
So, hey, funny story. Joe Rogan follows both of us.
Yeah.
And so we are actually going to get shirts made that say,
What's up, Joe? Hey,
Joe, are you listening to my podcast?
Joe, you're wearing my fucking shoes right now. And you love TJ, and you love Ed, and you like Tim, and like all these guys. So we're gonna do a shirt. It's gonna be funny as fuck. It's like Joe Rogan follows me, dude.
Right. Because that's awesome.
Yeah.
So I was watching his stand up a couple weeks ago, and I think it was three sheets to the wind. I'm like, hey, did I tell you Joe Rogan follows me? Like 3 seconds.
Oh, for
like,
real?
Hey, did I tell you Joe Rogan follows me? Anyway, that's funny.
So Joe, dude, you're just being yourself, man. But you're a badass motherfucker.
We're moving out of the shots fired. We're moving into the talk shit segment, right?
Yeah.
This is where we're just going to talk some shit because you are a veterpreneur, right?
Yeah, I'll talk.
I don't know if you like that terminology or not.
That's why people don't like me, because I talk this fucking shit out of stuff.
So you are a former special forces operator that got his master's in business, started the company Whoobies, which also was started on the roof of that hotel that night with the idea.
You're part of it.
I was part of it. I actually threw some money down on the very first order.
I still think I owe you some money.
You might still owe me a little bit.
I even know I think the spreadsheet's full of shit.
Hand job, reach around, we'll figure it out.
Fuck you.
But let's before we get to your transition from special forces to veterpreneur and where you've where Whoobie started and where it's going.
Yeah.
What did you do in the military? Tell us some war stories, bro.
Dude, I actually, it's not that sexy because I was in 2001, I joined and 9/11 happened during my basic training and I was a Patriot missile operator. And so I went to invasion Iraq right away and I would see these motherfuckers with like beards and playing Metallica and shit, you know, rolling up to the PX or something in Kuwait. I'd be like, dude, who the fuck are those bitches? Like, it's special forces. So I'm like, I'm going to be special forces or I'm going to get the fuck out of this army.
Right.
Because I don't want to be the regular army shit. It was like too much fucking politics. Even special forces kind of gone that way too. But, dude, we met and I was like, dude, I knew the synergy. I was like, dude, there's no such thing as a veteran owned shoe company. Mm-hmm. Not as special forces.
Yeah.
But what I did in special forces was, dude, I was in the Q course from 2003 to 2006, because I went to selection twice. I was an asshole, and I went back, you know, in 2004. and got selected. And I went through the whole course, and then I went to the Red Empire and the Green Berets, and they're like, my team was already in Afghanistan. So I went right into Afghanistan, and then watching some of my buddies I was in the course with going back in body bags, you know. They did graduate just right before me. I was like, damn, dude, I'm going to Bravo Company, you know, 3-7 right here. Anybody? 3-7, you guys know? And we were straight in gunfights every time we left the wire. You know, my first mission was a level 2-ish. We've been sitting on this for a while where we had to go to the Taliban sanctuary where they're teaching, right?
Right.
So we had to creep in on Humvees, not a helicopter assault. This is my first mission, and it took 3 days to get there. And then everybody's looking at us the whole time. You know, they got their fucking Motorolas on the hilltops and shit. Right. So we got ambushed like a motherfucker for 6 hours the first time we got there. I was on the 50 cal with no armor. I mean, I smoked 70 people right away. And then we stayed there. We fixed mortars. We dropped all the bombs we could. And then we stayed right in the town just to keep the fight going. And everybody was just dragging bodies out. Like, you know, all the fucking Taliban are dragging the bodies out.
Yeah, making grass grow in the hills.
We could see Spooky, our C-130. Yeah, AC-130. The AC-130. She was telling us, hey, dude, they're just dragging your bodies out, man. So we fixed mortars on the next morning, and we kept on going. We kept on killing people. And that was my way I got into the Green Berets, man, just getting all those kills and acting like a senior, you know, 18 Echo. And after that, I got reached from, you know, the agency and stuff like that. And I went to another selection, and I worked with another company, you know, if you will, funded by the same people. And it really opened my heart up. And then I worked with the SAS and the SRR in England. I lived there for a long time, and I learned about their situations and their problems.
So you've done a lot of operational shit. Non-permissive environment work. Yeah. You've been in active combat. You've been not necessarily in spy mode, but you've been in deep cover.
I have been
type.
In spy mode, yeah.
Well, you know, I didn't want to say
Yeah,
it,
yeah,
know.
Yeah, whatever.
But that's where your passion for the shoe company came to play. Yeah. You said something to me the other day, and I can't remember the wording. Who is it that you want to sell these shoes to? You said something like professionals or like operational.
Essential personnel.
Essential personnel.
Yeah.
You know, we're not talking about the essential personnel. In other words, like the DoorDashers that are essential and bringing me my food during the COVID.
By professionals for professionals.
But, you know, Whoopi shoes, you know, everybody messages me all the time. They're like, Altama or Whoopi's? Altama or Whoopi's? I'm like, Whoopi's. They're fucking designed in America and made in Texas by Green Berets. Mm-hmm. Come on.
Yeah.
You know, Tim Kennedy, for Christ's sake, wears them.
Yeah.
You know, I mean.
Yeah,
oh.
Yeah. Yeah.
I know some of you guys don't like Tim Kennedy because of his view on
age and guns. Yeah, whatever. I get that all the time.
Get fucked. Who
cares? Hey, Tim, let me set this straight
Tim
right now.
Tim Kennedy kissed me on the mouth once, and I liked it.
Let me set this straight right now. Tim Kennedy, I've known him for 20 years, and I'm looking at the camera right now. I don't give a fuck if you like him or not. If he says one thing on a podcast that you don't like, go fuck yourself. Because honestly, he's still growing, and I'm growing, and he's a good person. So
he's a great person.
If he says that you don't want to get dude, that was one moment in time. Dude, go fuck yourself, bitches.
We were talking about this today. The Black Rifle Coffee.
Fucking bitch ass.
Everybody bitching
dude.
About Black Rifle Coffee.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, you know, the snowflake cancel culture
dude,
bullshit.
Everybody wants to put their Twitter fingers, the trigger fingers and shit. Like, motherfuckers, dude, come over here and talk to me right now in St. Peter's and tell me how much of a problem you have with me. Because I guarantee you'd be fucking scared of me.
If you only want.
Those bitches.
If you only want to respect
motherfuckers.
If you only want to respect and or follow people that have exactly your same beliefs, you're fucked in life. Yeah. You're fucked in life.
Because I
guarantee
got,
the three of us right here.
You.
The three of us right here.
I got an uncle for you.
I
right
guarantee
there.
We all have different belief systems. Yeah. We have different opinions.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
And it's okay.
I don't want to live
it's anymore. Okay. Yeah. No, it's okay. And so I these guys that just judge somebody the Black Rifle thing. So they probably shouldn't have, you know, pushed away from the Kenosha thing the way they did. And, you know, and then they got all the hate from all the libtards coming to them with the cancel culture. Mm-hmm. That's what caused them to go into panic mode and, mm-hmm. And what I call it earlier, damage control.
Damage control.
And then
then
Evan makes a statement, and I guarantee you, we talked about it earlier.
Yeah.
His sales were probably through the roof last week.
Yeah.
Right. Even though everybody's like, fuck Black Rifle Coffee, blah, 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 blah. You know, I guarantee his sales were through the roof because that's what cancel culture does. It pisses off a small group of people and they get really loud, but then a huge group of people come to support their brand that they like or the person that they like. And it's just bad for everybody
involved, you know, I don't like,
except for the guy making all the money, which, according to the doxers, is Jewish liberals.
You know what I don't like, TJ, though? Like, you understand this? Like, honestly, at the end of the day, it doesn't matter if you're in shoes, you're in coffee, you're in fucking guns, you're in fucking dildos, right? Like, you're doing a good job, right? You're fucking making commerce. You're hiring Americans. People are buying your shit. And then you're hiring people that are taking their money to spend it on the economy. And there's these motherfuckers that have no life that are sitting there just talking shit.
Yeah.
And what are they doing?
Somebody said
the
other day.
What the fuck are you doing? What the fuck are you doing?
Somebody said they wanted to cancel Tactical Shit the other day, so I couldn't buy any more cars.
Like, we're fucking out here fucking hustling our asses off every goddamn day.
You know what?
This is part of what we do, man.
You know what I did the second I heard that? I went out and bought another fucking car.
Yeah. You got that G-Wagon.
Actually, it was after that, but yeah.
Yeah. So TJ and I were in the G-Wagon for Vermonte today, man. That shit.
Yeah, I took you on a little entrepreneurial tour.
But you and I have been doing this for a long time.
The spoils of entrepreneurial war.
But we were doing that a long time ago. Remember back in Vegas, dude, with that white one?
Me and this guy hit 150 mile an hour.
I wasn't there.
Dude.
Him and I hit 150 mile an hour on the Vegas Strip. I'm pretty sure the statute of limitations has got me out of that. We're not admitting the win.
That shit was sick, dude.
Yeah.
Which one he didn't get out of, though? When he was doing, like, what was it, 150 down to the desert that one time? You got pulled over because I was trying to.
Oh!
I still got out of it.
That's fucking funny as fuck. Oh, I remember. Dude, I remember those shots. Those things are sick as fuck, dude.
Yeah.
Is that when you were with the black one, right?
Yeah, I had a McLaren. No, I had an orange McLaren 650.
Dude.
It was an orange McLaren 650, and the cops pulled me over. I'm trying to follow the van on the way to Shots of Range Day. So I get pulled over. It's me and my daughter. And I see the van pull over in front of me, and these fuckers jump out with the sticks, tripod cameras, and camera and videotape the entire traffic stop.
Get the fuck out of here. No shit. Because they're like, dude, this is like, we haven't seen one of these motherfuckers in a long time.
Right.
You know, they're like, dude, we got to put this on the academy.
So we've only got a couple minutes.
Okay.
Let's talk about Whoopi Shoes.
Okay.
So you started Whoopi Shoes years ago.
Yep.
And tell me about the journey that's been, and where is Whoopi's at now, and where is it going?
Well, I mean, I really wanted to start my company and just have a shoe company that was made by veterans, special operations, and good customer service, good branding. However, I could not make my stuff in America. You know, it took me 3 years, and now we're handmade stitched in Texas.
Right. So originally the shoes were made in China, like everything else is. Yep. I think Altam is made in like somewhere else, someplace with
never
jungles.
Whatever. Yeah.
But they're heavier duty than my Altamas. I own both. I wear both. Yeah. I understand both. They're heavier duty than Altamas. They're a little bit lighter. The pull on the back is way more rugged and easier.
Do you see how it's not. So it's actually horizontal and not linear.
Right.
So you can pull it instead of trying to get in it, right? Like that.
And the reason SF guys love these Chuck Taylor styled shoes is because they fit in flippers, right?
Yep.
And so these have a really solid front toe section.
Well, it's got the TPU on there and then that insole that everybody loves.
This insole's like walking on jelly. Love it. Yeah, it actually makes my feet feel good.
Dude, it took me 6 months to make that insole like on the CAD system.
Yeah.
Yeah, the French Foreign Legion to the U.S. Army Green Berets Special Dive School. I mean, that sole system is even more rugged than a Vibram sole.
Yeah.
But I wanted to make sure that I can get. I don't want to be big all the way. Like I didn't want to get super big right away because I could have put a Vibram on there, right?
Right.
But it's Whoopi's sole system.
What's a Vibram?
Exactly. But
I'm serious. I have no idea what that is.
That sole system and my shoes. Are you can look at our fucking reviews and this is only the first year. Like, wait until 2 years from now. I mean, dude, Phil Knight, everybody are like I'm like, I might make a Jordan shoe one day. You know what I'm saying?
Hell yeah. So here's the deal. Yeah. So Tony comes to me and, you know, he's like, look, We're high-end, dude. We're made in America. These shoes are expensive. They're $109.
High-end as fuck.
Yeah, they're high-end as fuck. We're like, the, you know, like, he's like the Kanye West of Green Berets.
Yeah.
And, you know, and I'm like, dude, I'll tell you what, just give me something. Give me something. You're coming to town. Let me do something. And so you are allowing me one time to break your rules and sell these shoes at a bit of a discount.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So right motherfucking now, until the 15th of December, we're running these on a Christmas sale. Mm-hmm. They're $79.99. So 25% off, $79.99. So it puts them in the price comparison to the shoe that's made in the other countries.
I'm really sorry for all time. I mean, you guys called me. You know, we had a beef. We'll talk
about sell both.
Hey, hold on. We'll talk about that on a, maybe another podcast.
Right, right. Yeah, we don't want to go into that.
Yeah, we'll talk to that about that beef and like Canada. Yeah. We'll talk about how they call me and they're like, hey, dude, can we sell this real quick? You know what I mean? Like, because I'm killing it, dude. Yeah.
So right now you can order these at Whoobies.com, right?
Whoobieshoes.com.
Whoobieshoes.com. Whoobies, like your favorite.
Yeah, I tried to buy Whoobies and then these bitch-ass motherfuckers were like, dude, they own like a cat fucking store that's out of business and they wanted to sell it to me for fucking $12,000. I'm like, dude, I ain't buying Whoobies.com
just
for that
keep,
shit.
Just keep checking. They will get they will get sick of paying the $14 a year for it.
But they're out of, like, I was like, dude, later. Fuck you, bitch.
Yeah we just did that with Tactical SHT, right? TacticalSHT.com. Yeah. Some guy was squatting on it, wanted $1,800. And I just kept telling him, fuck off, fuck
that's
off,
it.
Fuck
squatting,
off.
Dude. And, it's squatting. That's
and next
all
thing you
is.
Know, you know, like, I checked on it the other day. It was fucking available for 99 cents a year. I'm like, done. You know, because he got sick of squatting on it, you know? So that's the thing.
Fucking bitches.
Play them out if you got the time.
Fucking bitches.
So, Whoobies, we got Tim Kennedy is like your flagship guy, right? He's leading the charge.
I'm the flagship guy.
Well, I meant like as far as influencers go.
Well,
but
he's
there's
one of them.
There's another guy. I'm trying to keep you on time here. There's another guy that you're doing a collab with right now that I'm a huge fan of, Ed Manifesto. How the fuck did you start hanging out with Ed Manifesto in Tijuana is what I want
to
know.
Dude, I've been in Tijuana like two times in the last 30 days.
Yeah?
Yeah, dude. Ed likes Mod 1s, and I like what he does, and I'm a dark-ass motherfucker, and I like Holy Death and stuff like
I
wanna that.
I want to get Ed on this podcast because he's probably got some crazy stories.
We can do that.
Crazy stories to tell.
But, dude... Dude, him and I become like he's my fucking dude.
Yeah, I've seen you guys doing a lot. You guys are doing a hoodie right now. It's a collab hoodie.
Yeah, we did $100,000 on a hoodie in like 3 hours. Like, and
this is called the Smuggler hoodie.
And we never we didn't really market it, dude. It was just me and Tijuana. You know, you don't even know the attributes or anything.
So tell me about this Smuggler's hoodie.
It's like a a Carhartt hoodie.
Yeah.
You know how heavy it is.
Right.
Times it by two.
Okay.
And then you have two pockets in the hood.
Yeah.
Like covert zippers.
Right.
You got two pockets on the chest, covert. You also have two pockets on the sleeves, covert.
So if you're like smuggling 9mm, let's say.
Oh, perfect.
You got plenty of places to put it.
And then you have elastic straps inside the kangaroo pouch.
Mm-hmm.
Where you put maps and stuff and money in.
Okay.
And then there's a zipper where you can pull out your tourniquet or your Glock.
You're saying from inside the kangaroo pouch. Mm-hmm. So I could access my appendix carry. My blade.
Think about that.
Can I access my
everything?
My Dynamis blade.
Everything.
I had to find it. My fat ass belly had it pulled over to the side.
So this hoodie, dude, you just reach out and you got everything. And we also have handcuff key pockets in the waistline. The little two fingers.
Yeah.
Boom. This thing is made for the heroin smuggler going through the border or the CIA agent that needs to go undercover. And clandestine.
Right on.
Like, this is from A to Z.
Yeah.
And I don't give a fuck who I sell it to either. You know what I mean? Because I'm just making good content.
Sure.
I'm making good stuff. You know, like you said, like, we're making good stuff. And if you want to buy it, I don't give a fuck if you're a Jew. I don't give a fuck if you, I don't give a fuck if you're a Christian. I don't give a fuck if you're, like, honestly, I don't care who you are, what color you are. We're just coming out with good shit.
Will you sell it to liberals?
Yeah.
Okay, you had to think about that one at least.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was funny. I
think liberals will actually be buying this whole thing.
I met a lieutenant colonel the other day, a Pentagon guy, who had some choice things to say about liberals that I never expected to come out of.
No. Because he works with all liberals, too.
Right.
Yeah. But listen, I'm a businessman, but I just like putting out good gear, you know, and I have my heart in the right spot, so... Like, everybody go fuck themselves, man. Be honest with you.
You heard it right here.
It's like what Nick said, you know, when he started Range 15, everybody go fuck themselves.
Yeah.
Like, Like, dude, you guys can literally, if you don't like me, I don't give a fuck. I got a fucking hot ass girl. I got a couple of them. I like to smoke cigarettes sometimes. I smoke a lot of weed and I fucking drink, dude. And I'll get sober again one day, but I don't give a fuck. I put out good shit.
You know, I'm in the process of getting sober again.
Yeah, I know you are.
I'm two weeks clean right now.
TJ took me to his house. We were talking about it, man. It was like super special. I'm going to start coming out here like once a quarter, dude.
Yeah, you should hang out, dude.
What did I do when I came here?
He fucking went back in the back and started helping shipping.
Yeah.
He was packing up ammo.
You guys see that? You got that Whoopi's crew right there? So I come here. What am I fucking doing? I'm fucking shipping. For real.
Right on. So Whoopi's is going to take over the world. If Whoopi's are not on your feet, you need to order them from Tactical Shit. Shop.tacticalshit.com. Mm-hmm. Right motherfucking now, because that sale ends on the 15th of December, and you may or may not ever see it priced that low again, because Tony probably won't let me. So get them while we'll you can. We are going to be selling a lot of Whoopi's in 2021. Oh, we like supporting American-made products.
We got high tops coming through. We got these hooks.
I'm still waiting for the FDEs.
I know,
You know, maybe some Rhodesian.
I'm wearing them right now.
I'd like some Rhodesian camo. You
know? That shit right there, guys.
Yeah, he's got the only FDE Whoopi's in the world.
In the world.
And I got to say, too,
he's on charity.
I still love my old Chinese Whoopi's because they are
really?
they are like the most comfortable slippers.
Give me a fucking hug.
They are the, they are the most comfortable slippers ever.
No, you know, I'm serious, dude. I was doing my best, man. I was being my best man I could be at that time, dude.
The bottoms ripped out of them. They fell apart, but they still slip on your feet. You know?
Yeah.
Anyway, this is the story of an American company started by a veteran that is now doing very successful, getting ready to have their first $1 million year. Congratulations,
Thank
Tony.
Thank
Thanks
you,
for
man.
Coming.
Our first $1 million year started 6 months ago, though.
Yeah. Well, yeah, because you got that beautiful fiscal year in the middle thing.
Yeah.
I got a deal January from December.
Dude, making my first million was crazy, man. It still is right now.
It's a big deal.
It's a big deal, dude.
You know, tactical shit. You know, as an entrepreneur, the thing that, you know, like our website has a little tally of all the money we've ever made up in the corner.
Yeah.
And we hit $25 million the other day. Mm. And I was like, wow, that's a big
deal. Dude, you know what car I'm driving?
What?
2015 Chevy Malibu.
Nice.
Do you think I should get the upgrade?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I think so. You know what I was driving when I was first running Tactical Shit?
Yeah, what?
It was a retired detective's police cruiser. I paid $3,000.
Oh, with the light on it?
Yeah, it had the light on it.
You fucking ghetto ass motherfucker.
Everybody, I could drive it drunk and nobody'd ever pull me over. And if I got in the fast lane, everybody got out of the way.
Dude, this dude. I don't know if you guys, I'm fucking hitting this dude right now. Dude, you. So before we got to go, like, TJ and I have a lot in common. That's it. Gotta go. We have a go.
All right. That's the end of the podcast. Remember, the podcast is sponsored by Gunspot.com. If you want to buy guns on auction, if you want machine guns, go to Gunspot.com. It's fun just to shop Gunspot.com because they got all the HKs and the Saws and the M60s and all the fun shit that, you know, like, you can see the pricing on machine guns. Gunspot.com. We also want to thank, who else do we want to thank? Whip Machine, the SME, which is also going on sale when? Today? Okay, the Whip Machine SME is on sale today. 20% off shop.tacticalshit.com. We're trying to get you guys some Christmas gifts, and that's it. I'm out of here. See you guys later.
Bye.